welcome to this week's episode of Friday Night Mail. Before we get into it, I have a few announcements. First of all, I would like to let you guys know that I have upgraded my production quality once more. I am now using the Canon 5D Mark III rather than the Canon Rebel T5i. Canon Rebel T5i is like an introductory DSLR, whereas the Mark III is like one of the best on the market. And once again, I would like to thank my patrons and anyone who has supported me, because without you guys, I would not be able to afford this kind of equipment. And I geek out over it like crazy, so thank you so much. I also now get to use my Rebel as a fucking webcam. My gaming production quality is like through the fucking roof now. Also, I have a lot of stuff today, but I wanted to go over something real quick with you guys. I'll be brief, I promise. I'll try to be brief. I see a few people in the comments saying that they wish they could get me stuff and they feel bad that they can't get me stuff, or they feel bad that they can't support on Patreon. And I want to let you guys know why you should not feel that way. Basically, the way I see it is it's not about the money that you donate or the items that you send me. It's about wanting to support. So like, if you don't have the means to support, but you want to support someone who's trying to make a living doing what they love, that to me basically just sets you leagues apart from the assholes that say things like,
why would you spend money on someone else? Use your money better. Why would anyone send her anything?
Like, those people are just selfish assholes that don't respect me. But like, if you watch my content and then click that like button, it means you enjoy the content that I create, and it helps me vastly, and I really appreciate it. Just watching my content, that's it, and being positive. Obviously, I really appreciate the people who do donate money and send me things. But honestly, with me, it's just the thought that counts. I fucking love you all. All right, let's get into it. First thing we've got is from Joseph Michaels, AKA The Adventurous Joe. I will post a link to his content down in the description. He's a pretty badass content creator and a good friend of mine. So if you haven't already, check it out and subscribe. Let's see what he sent me this time. It's Rey's lightsaber. Holy shit. I think it needs batteries, but this is fucking badass. Thank you, Joe. I've always wanted one of these lightsabers that lights up. This is sick. I'm actually gonna do a dedicated Star Wars stuff unboxing next weekend because I have so much Star Wars stuff. That'll be over on the gaming channel at youtube.com/TerraBabcockGames. We've got a manila envelope from Nicholas H. Let's see what's in it. It says, read out loud, sorry for my bad handwriting. Tara, a while back I asked you for an interview about sociology and heavy metal. You said you were very busy at the time and couldn't do it, which I totally understand. You're a busy person. I was able to find 14 people who love heavy metal as much as you, and I was still able to do the study. That's fucking awesome. Even though you weren't able to participate, I thought you might want to read it since you like sociology and heavy metal. I totally understand if you don't have time. It's a long paper. I would love to get your feedback on it if you do end up reading it. But again, no rush. Thank you so much for understanding, and thank you so much for sending me this. Didn't I tell you I wanted to read it? I'm actually very interested. Anytime you want to talk about sociology, metal, League of Legends, feel free to contact me. I would love to chat with you. I also run a small YouTube channel over at youtube.com/lastzackna. I'll post the link in the description. I'm a Diamond Zack one trick pony, just like you with Vygar. Hey, thanks for all the great content. And then there's a part that I get to read to myself. Oh, thank you so much. I'm gonna add you on League right after I'm done with this. And here's the paper. Let's read an excerpt. Since the inception of heavy metal in 1970 with the release of the first Black Sabbath record, Massachusetts Institute of Technology 2014, that was a reference by the way, didn't need to read that, heavy metal has been painted by the media as a consistent source of controversy. One of the first major controversies happened when Ozzy Osbourne bit the head off a bat during a concert in 1982, fueling a panic about the nefarious intentions of metal musicians. Not long after, the Parents Music Resource Center, PMRC, compiled a list of 15 primarily hard rock and metal songs that they deemed the Filthy 15, because they viewed their lyrics as objectionable. A few years later, in 1985, the PMRC held a conference that resulted in the new common parental advisory stickers that we use today, a practice that perpetuates the idea that some music, particularly heavy metal and rap, is unsuitable. I'm actually really interested to read this. Thank you so much for sending it to me. I'm really sorry that I didn't get to meet up with you and talk about it. I really apologize. I wish I had more time to do stuff like that. But I haven't even found the time in the last week to walk across the street and pick up my prescription for my eyes. I should probably do that. You're awesome. Expect a friend request on League. Next. Oh yay, we've got notes. I fucking love notes. LMT, may you like these gloves. Lovely shiny material. The fuck is this? It's a little baggie that says good turn and it has a zebra on it. All right. Rectal exam rubber tongue. Good boy rubber. Next. Oh, it's a gift from Alex. Always supporting your makeup addiction. Love, Alex. Oh, thank you so much. I have a hard time doing eyeshadow and I've always wanted to do a smoky eye, and I think this will help a lot. Also, I ran out of eyeliner, so I could use it as both. Thank you, Alex. You are so fucking beautiful. And because I'm addicted to looking at Alex right now, I'm gonna post her link in the description, so go follow her on Instagram. Mwah! Love you, baby girl. Next, we've got this tiny thing. It's another gift from Alex. NYX Waterproof It Waterproof Eyebrow Primer. Let's go ahead and like put it on, because why the fuck not, right? Who doesn't need some eyebrow primer after they've done their makeup? Oh, now it looks like I have jizz in my eyebrows. Thank you, baby. Now my eyebrows won't be going all over the place and they'll hold color better. Mwah. You are just so sexy. I can't get over it. Next, this is from Rubber Tongue and this is for Jay's birthday. I don't know if he can hear me or not, but it's a Mario ugly Christmas sweater. Good boy, Rubber Tongue.
Next item.
Holy shit. Hi, LMT. Some sexy stockings included too. I don't have many of these stockings. Does it actually? Oh shit. So these stockings actually come with underwear and the underwear is attached to the garments and the stocking. So you don't have to have like those ugly clip garters. I approve, Rubber Tongue. I think he's buying me a whole sexy outfit. I can't tell. No way, you guys. You guys have to see this. Oh my God. Hi Tara, I hope you enjoyed this black squirting dildo. Wait, what? That's not what I got in this package. You and Jay can get freaky with it. Okay, well this is Giovanni's black squirting dildo. Sex for dummies. Enjoy healthy sexuality throughout life. I feel like a lot of the people in the comment section should have this book. But this is awesome. Maybe I can get ideas for sex ed. I love all of the feminist sex teachers and how they're always like really old. Oh my God, old people still have sex. Anyway, this is a really thoughtful gift and I'm actually really glad to have this. Thank you so much, Giovanni. I look forward to the squirting black dildo. Look guys, it's the anus. Empty package. Of course, LMT, you would need a badass necklace too. No. Okay. One tape down, 100 to go. Ooh, I feel so fancy.
With my family amulet. Ooh.
The coldness of this necklace actually feels really good against my just tanned skin. Just what the mistress ordered. We've got another package from Joseph Michaels. And look at how I found it in my P.O. box. Like, who the fuck is snooping in my shit? First thing is Star Wars Showdown on the Smuggler's Moon. Some people in the comments were saying they don't like how I handle comic books. And then I asked what they meant and I don't think they replied. But I feel like I'm pretty careful with them. So I'm confused. A must read for any enthusiast. Enthusiast of what? Luke's blonde asshole. Oh my God, another Darth Vader one. I'm so happy. Shadows and Secrets. Awesome. And another one, Vader Down. I love the Darth Vader ones. And I love the fucking art style of these. Holy shit. So fucking gorgeous. Thank you, Joseph. I'm actually gonna have a comic book collection. I can't believe it. Holy shit, what is this? Oh, awesome. It's the official Injustice game guide. Jay and I were just recently playing this game. How did you know? Thank you so much, Joseph. You are amazing. His link in the description. Mwah. All right, now we move on to the boxes. Topwedding.com. Queen LMT, why go for a crown when you can get a tiara? The I is in parentheses because without the I, you spell Tara. And another one, oh LMT, please scratch me. So kinky. Everyone knows by now that you are a little slut. Yep, he's dressing me up, that's for sure. There we go. How do I look? And we also have these. Gonna have to take one of these off. Holy crap. Who needs a box cutter when you have these? These are like really crazy. I love it. This is actually pretty hot. Holy shit! I just opened it with my nail. Hi LMT, wanted you to have a badass pirate corset. Oh my God. Holy shit. We so have to put this on. Okay, I have to take these off to do it. I'll be right back. Okay everyone, I think now is the time you say thank you to Rubber Tongue. This outfit is hot. Okay, this is the letter that was supposed to go with the book. Hi Tara, judging from your YouTube channel, I assume that you're a good girl and a virgin, so I got you this book. Enjoy. Haha, Giovanni.
Let this 8.5 big boy fill you up.
Shit.
8.5 inches, realistic look and feel, comes anywhere you want on command.
Phthalate free body safe material, which I talked about recently in the sex ed before the last, I think.
Proudly made in America. America, the land of the big black dicks.
Haha, yes. Thank you so much, Giovanni. Whoa, I just threw one of my nails. And it comes with a little bottle of cum. Who doesn't want their dildo to come with a little bottle of splooge? Smells really good. This is actually really cool. I'm gonna cum all over Jay's face. This was actually a gift on Twitch from Macarion. Thank you so much. It's Connor, one of my favorite assassins. Holy fucking shit, this is way more amazing than I thought it was. Can you guys see it? There you go. I'm gonna have to do a whole unboxing of this. Blah. It says Animus Database, and it shows his tomahawk, his rifles, his bow. This is exceptional. Thank you so much. This is literally like amazing. We've got one more box. Hiya, Tara. A little something for the sexy badass on the go. Keep on being amazing, because the only thing sexier than your chest is your shining personality. And no, that is not a joke. Sincerely, Brandon. Aw. Let's see what we got. On the go. Is it an on-the-go dildo? Yay! It's my 64-ounce thermos! I don't know about on-the-go. I was literally gonna put like 6 bottles or 4 bottles, 4.5, into this and use it as a thing for drinking while I'm streaming. And I'm gonna stream after this, so thank you so much, Brandon. This is awesome! Perfect color, too. And it keeps things cold for up to 12 hours. Ugh, thank you. There's one more thing, actually. I got it. Last thing. I can't wait. What is this? It's this sexy thong. This sexy overshirt. I'm gonna go ahead and assume that this is from Rubber Tongue. Love it! I should wear it with absolutely nothing on. Thank you so much, you guys. This was an amazing fucking Friday night mail. Oh, one of my best so far. So many fucking awesome and amazing presents. You guys are just the fucking best. Thank you to everyone who watches my videos, sends me anything, supports on Patreon, supports on Twitch, or just spends time listening to what I have to say or looking at my boobs. You guys are all fucking amazing, and do not forget it. And remember, next time you feel bad because you haven't sent me anything, I get more than I deserve anyway, and I appreciate everything you're already doing. Believe me when I say it is the thought that counts. Just being there for me and watching my content is all I need. This stuff doesn't hurt, it's really fun, but it's not necessary at all. And it's especially not necessary if you just want my respect and admiration. I fucking love you guys. Thank you so much. I hope you have a wonderful fucking weekend, and I hope to see you on stream with my new upgraded quality. I even got a new mic. No more needing to wear a headset and ruining my hair. I think I'll actually use this outfit for this week's In-Between Fanservice Friday on Patreon. Good idea, right? All right, guys, like the video and subscribe to the channel if you're enjoying the content. Don't forget to check out some of my other videos, links in the description, and I will see you next Friday with a Friday Night Mail. And remember, if you want to send me anything at all, anything legal, my address is always in the description and it's attached to my Amazon wishlist. Bye, guys. Mwah.